Welcome back to next one. In this session, we are going to discuss how to create different property file. So let's say we are working on a different environment. So I'm testing my APIs on staging environment, dev environment, or further environment. So for each environment, we have to define a detail. So using that, we can run our test in multiple environments. So we are going to keep those details. So we are going to keep those details inside the input folders. So inside there we need to create a simple file. So let's say first I'm going to test for the dev environment. So we need to create a property file for dev environment. So here you can give any environment name, and main thing is extension. So extension will be a properties. properties. So do not misspelled about this property. Yeah, so we have created for dev environment. Similar way, we can create a multiple property file for another environment. So let's say for I'm creating for staging environment, staging dot properties, and we are going to add one more environment, so which is QA dot properties. So don't worry, we are going to discuss how we are running our test in multiple environments. So finish. Now the thing is, what we need to give here, or what information this property file should have. So first will be server URL. So simply you can define whatever server URL we are going to have, or based on your server. So let's say for example https://www.test.com. So this will be my server URL. After that, let's say we are going to test for some particular user, or we are going to set username or password details for this particular environment. So we can have username which is test, password admin, then we can have different or authorization type or server port number. So let's say port number is going to consume 8080, so we can have port number 8080. So this kind of information we can have. So for each server there will be a separate information, so we are going to keep for this all the server, and we need to just change the values for the based on the server. So let's say for staging you have URL will be the same, but port number will be 8585. So you can define here port number, and user will be a, let's say, staging user, and password will be admin. So like this we can define the information here, and while running our test we are going to consume this information. So now next thing, we are going to build a utility for how to consume this data. So this will be my file and environment. Using that we are going to consume this data. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching.